1 week to go till Bonds night, but still time to get some practice in.
Leslie, if you're there, pick up. Leslie.
Like, if you think I'm going to beg, you can forget it.
Aye, you're wishing you wore your sports bra now, eh?
Please, Leslie. Please, I'm begging you.
So, next week is, of course, Burns Night and the National Burns Poetry Recital Competition. And at the Cayley, we are giving our entrant the traditional send-off into the contest.
OK. Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? Let's say a few words while we're still compos mentis. Once more, we're off into battle to bring home that most precious of prizes, the Cup of Kindness.
Here we are.
Shush, you really haven't got on with it.
And let us not forget the man whose fine young shoulders carry the hopes and dreams of us all here at the Dumfriesburn Society. I mean, of course, young Struan Robertson himself. Where are you, son? Stand there. That's my boy now. If you'd all like, just like to charge your glasses and drink the toast with me, thank you, to the great man himself, I give you the Bard.
The Bard!
Oh dear.
It's over.
Struan.
This will be my 27th year organising the competition. I've never missed a year except the one when I was away in Bristol meeting potential sperm donors. We start putting everything together around February, so it's really a year-round thing for me, partly because there's so much to do and partly because I've got nothing else in my life. But I love it, really. Who doesn't like Burns? You tell me that.
Hayley! Downstairs now and I'll thrash you! Hayley! Oh, you shift! Oh!
Right, we've done the ballet, haven't we? Bought her all the stuff for that. Horse riding.
Oh, do you remember we even went through a phase of the ice skating? So eventually I said to her, all right then, Hayley, we've tried all my ideas. Okay, so what do you want to do? And what did you say? She said, I want to do poetry. I was like, all right then. Where's this come from? But she said, a poetry recital, a Burns poetry recital. I thought, I don't know where this has come from, but okay, what do you want me to buy you for that then? Do you know what she said? Nothing.
Nothing? That's right, a mind of that. Oh, her face was a study.
Wheel mounted on his grey mare Meg, a better never lifted leg. Tam skelpit on through dub and mire, despising wind and rain and fire.
I'm passionate about literature. I've got the kind of brain that's good with words and things. Very creative. There's a lot going on the right-hand side. Like, for example, if you say the word to me, apple, I immediately see very, very clearly in my head an apple.
Yum.
And left poor Maggie scarce a stamp!
Ooh, now that was good. I was pleased. Good. Another cup of tea.
I will you still, my dear. Oh, she's gone dry.
It was great to get any a bit of the Bard, eh? I mean, it's definitely an eye-opener for me. I mean, me and him are like people who, you know, have an ability, if I can put it like that, to sort of, you know, make a connection with the opposite sex. Maybe that's why I've got 9 kids.
Should old acquaintance be... What?
I'm a Burns fanatic, yeah. That's why I work here, you know?
I'm one of the gardeners. But what I admire about Burns is, you know, he didn't have it easy, you know. He struggled. Bit like my brother, aye. He works in the quick fit, aye, during the day, and then 3 nights a week he's got a bar job because he's up to his eyes in his visa.
The competition's important, obviously, but, you know, it's not life or death.
Not every year.
No. But it is important because Dumfries has been the holder of the trophy for the past 6 years, mm-hmm. which just happens to be the same length of time that I have been here in office as president.
Well, I didn't know the first thing about Burns, really, until I moved up here, what with not being from here. Oh, I'm originally from Guildford in Surrey. Surrey lass, born and bred. I moved up to Scotland about 6 months ago, I think it was. My husband, Boyd, well, he was less keen on the idea initially, but I just felt it was time for a change of scene. I mean, when we saw this place, we just fell in love with it. We really did. I said to Boyd, I said, this is home. And that's us. We're done roaming, as they say. And as far as quality of life is concerned, the people up here have made us feel so welcome. It's fantastic. And we've just settled in. And that's thanks to the warmth of the Scotch folk. Mm. There you go, darling.
Thanks. What bag's that you've got there? What have I told you? Where is the bag that I got you? Now, come on, go inside and get it.
She's a very lucky girl. There's a lot of children that do not have the privileges that my Hayley's got.
Much better. Shut the door, were you born in a barn? Go and lock the bloody door.
You see, I didn't have anything like this when I was growing up. Kids came last in our house. I mean, I suppose you could say I didn't really have a childhood. No. No, I mean, it was tough. You grew up fast. You were out of work as soon as you got your first gyro. Made up for it, though. See, my 20s. Oh, boy, did I let the brakes off. I did everything, you name it. Oh, I was... But then, I suppose there is a price to be paid for everything, unfortunately. And that was where we Hayley came along, didn't you?
You had a bike.
My love is like a red, red rose that's newly sprung in June. My love is like the melody that's sweetly played in tune.
I fathered my first child when I was 14, and then I got married when I was 16. Well, only because she was pregnant. And then she had twins and she was depressed. So she wasn't up for it. So I started getting my hole elsewhere. So I went and met another girl on the internet, and we were together for like 2 years until she started asking me for money for like shoes and clothes and nappies and stuff. And that was the point I realised I had to grow up. You know, start facing reality. I either went out there and got myself a full-time job or I started robbing petrol stations with my wee boy's air rifle.
Till all the seas gang dry, my dear, and the rocks melt with the sun. And I will love thee still, my dear, while the sands of life shall run.
Some people see prison as a punishment and a place to just put people, and I find that very sad.
If I can get a prisoner to engage with a book or a poem, then there's a good chance we can get them to the stage where they're going to be able to walk out those gates and never come back. And as for the guys themselves, they love it. They really do. It's the one time in a week where they're totally engaged in something positive, or to wear a 10,000 mile. Why do you think he compares his love to a rose? Well, think about it, a rose, a flower. Stevie?
Well, because Rose was pure, like a part of nature, and it smells nice and that sort of thing.
That's fantastic. So he's comparing his love for a woman, to a rose. But why a red one?
Oh, because all their best bits are red.
Aye, Robert's all right. But it is a bit of a shame what happened to him. You see, there used to be a horse that we had here, and it used to get tied up outside by the bikes, and Robert would feed it and sort it out. But what happened was that it got chewing gum stuck in its hoof off of one of the kids that had spat it out, and Robert was trying to get it to lift up its back leg so we could get his pen in and dig it out.
Did I have a wheelbarrow? Oh, gee.
The next thing, I just heard this noise and the horse was up on its hind legs going mental, kicking and screaming. And Robert took the full force of it, whacked him on the head. Robert's never been the same, I reckon. Short-term memory shot to pieces and he was diagnosed with equinophobia, fear of horses. He doesn't eat chewing gum anymore either.
Oh, I feel fine. I mean, the memory thing's a bit of a pain. Like last week I was supposed to go out for my dinner and I've ended up ordering in a pizza. Then I ate the pizza, then I forgot I ate the pizza and went out for my dinner anyway. But to be honest, I don't really think about it now. It's like it hardly ever happened, really.
When Chapman Billy's leave the street and Druthy neighbours meet. It's better. I decided to enter. Gosh, now how did I find out about it? Oh yeah, that's right. I saw it in the news agents on the board thing that they have.
Oh yeah, it's where they advertise, you know, young foreign nannies, Polish.
And I immediately thought this would be a great thing to get involved with. Appreciate a bit of the culture, the indigenous pastimes of the region that we've come to live in. You know, just show our warmth to the lovely people up here. Yeah.
Mm. It's a stroke of luck, really, given, I mean, we'd only gone in there to get some batteries for your taser.
Boyd, you should be wearing gloves doing that.
It's fine.
You'll cut yourself.
No, I won't.
I just think if you just...
It's fine.
All right.
Paula, get me a plaster. A big one!
How do you keep a marriage fresh? Well, I think you listen. I think you listen.
Yeah.
If you don't listen, I think, if you're not a listener, then you're stuffed, aren't you? I think we listen, don't we?
Oh, yeah.
Good morning, Governor. Nice weekend?
It was lovely, thank you. I was down in Hull speaking at a conference.
Oh, were you? What about?
Restoring the death penalty. Good laugh, actually.
Governor...
Not that I'm in favour of it, you understand. No. Chemical castration, now that's a different matter. That is the future. I see myself as a traditionalist. You know, I mean, I believe in old-fashioned values. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, a noose for a nonce. The Sarahs of this world, they see people like me as dinosaurs, but answer me this. Who would you rather deal with those bastards that robbed your granny? T-Rex or a wee lassie with a knitting degree?
Governor, I wanted to talk to you about Stevie.
Animal.
Oh. Well, that's one way of looking at him.
Yes, it is.
You know, he's really showing a lot of interest in the poetry classes I've been running.
Is he really?
Oh, yes. And I was wondering what you might think about him taking part in the National Burns recital competition.
Sorry?
Well, it's a fantastic opportunity.
You want me to let that man out?
I think it would be great, not just for the...
You want me to let that man out?
Well, I think it would be...
Here's a wee poem for you, Sarah. No.
OK, here we go. Right, so this is the girls. My girls. My team. We're all rooting for wee Hayley, aren't we? Right, so, how's it going? What has been happening?
The police were in.
What? Were they in for what?
Someone got stabbed in the face outside Farnford's last night.
All right, that's all right then. Yes, you know, we are a happy little bunch here. Quite stressful, you know, but that is the world of the financial services. So what do we do? We do, like, insurance, mortgages, look after people's tax, advise them on, like, what forms to fill in and how to avoid paying it. You know, but as I say, quite a pressurised job. Quite a high turnover of staff. I mean, like, take Sandra over there. Yeah, she is. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna sack her later.
Okay, let's make a deal. I think that Stevie can win this competition if he gets the chance, and I'm willing to put the future of the unit on the line to prove it.
So, if he doesn't win this competition, I get to close down your wee playgroup.
Yes.
That will do for me. One condition, though. Handcuffed at all times.
Okay.
Do you know, I am not a betting man, but that has livened up my day. Come on, I'll take you at the yard, show you where the gallows used to be.
Hello? Struan?
The wife might have tidied up before she buggered off.
Morning.
Oh, no, Struan, son, no.
Oh, this one. Dear, oh,
do.
I'll open the window, eh?
Aye, quick.
Oh, Gagga, come on, Struan. Come on, son, this isn't the attitude, is it? You're a winner, Struan. Say it to me, son. I am a winner.
I'm a winner.
That's the stuff.
That's you, boy.
Again, say it again.
I'm a winner.
That's
yes.
Right. That's very good.
Oh, no. Oh, shit.
What?
Oh. Oh, dear.
Oh.
Oh.
How'd you keep your washing machine, son?
Oh, dear.
Salma. Look, snowdrops. I planted them myself.
Oh, cheers.
Oh, just watch the manure on the roots there. I remember seeing Salma on her first day, you know. She was down on her hands and knees separating out fridge magnets, and I thought, wow, there's somebody that's as dedicated to Burns as I am. You still coming to see me in the competition?
I think so.
All right, brilliant.
Might be a bit late, though.
That's okay.
And I might not be able to stay till the end.
Well, that's all right. do you want to hear my poem?
Go on.
Should old acquaintance be...
forgot?
No, I'll get it in a minute. I've actually got a bit of a surprise for her. She doesn't know it yet, but I'm going to ask her to marry me the night of the competition. Aye, I'm just going to wait till I'm up on stage just before I do my poem. My brother thinks I should ask her out first, but I'm just going to go for it. Well, I figured, you know, I'm a Burns fanatic and... well, that's what he would have done, you know, the old romantic rabbi. Plus, if it's in front of a big crowd, there's less chance of her being able to say no.
It is obviously a strain holding down a full-time job and being a mum. You know, but just because I'm a single parent does not mean that Hayley has to go without.
I don't know who Hayley is. Today's the first day I've ever heard of her.
What, is that her daughter?
She said something about a competition, but... No, she's never mentioned her before. Didn't even know she had a daughter, did you?
No. Who'd she call?
As you know, I am separated from Hayley's dad. By choice. Partly. I mean, just because one person decides that they want to stick at it and the other one decides they want to be a woman. What can you do?
Isabel, that's old Mrs. Fraser on the phone.
Oh, Christ. Yes.
She said she spoke to you in the week and she said she's absolutely sure she's wanting to cash in that policy.
Right, and did you tell her that it was all linked to the FTSE and the housing market and everything like that, and she would be as well just to hang on to it for a wee while longer?
She said she spoke to her son-in-law who works for the Halifax and he said she's to do it now.
Right, OK, then we'll tell her to make an appointment to come in and see me tomorrow.
You're not in tomorrow though, Isabel.
You see... performing isn't a new thing for me. I'm an ex-professional dancer. I have all my qualifications, jazz, tap, modern. I danced in front of Princess Diana when she came to open the garden centre I was working at. Wasn't scheduled, but I thought, take my opportunity. My own legs are still in reasonable nick, yeah? I can still do the splits as long as I got my joggers on. Well, you know what they say. You can take the girl out of stage school, but you can't take stage school out of the girl. And all that jazz!
Oh, my God! Oh, my God! Is that a cat?
Yeah. Don't worry, though. It's dead.
Right, listen. Banking the petty cash. Nobody worry about it. I'm going into town, going to get Hayley kicked out for the competition. So I'll just drop it in. OK? Oh, Sandra. I haven't forgotten it's your last day. Bye-bye, love.
Squashing me, Michael.
He's squashing me, Michael. He has not got a seatbelt on.
It's you're
just
on big,
stop
fat
it, the pair of you. This is Struan's day. And he's right up for it, aren't you, son?
Oh, God.
Oh, dear. Oh, whoops-a-daisy. Hey, Cameron, where's that wee polly bag? Oh, you better put that handy.
I did not put that.
Oh,
Oh dear.
Well, of course, he's unassailable, that boy. Yeah. He's unassailable, isn't he?
That's to say he can't be caught.
No,
that's
true. I think he will just walk it.
Yes.
As usual. I think he will.
He's in a guddle, Michael. He's what? Not organised.
Oh. I have not as yet stated I don't have the bag.
Right, well, where is it then?
I don't know.
This is a repeat of the fiasco with a flask.
I'm fine, okay? Just shut up, the lot of you.
Yeah, well said. Now, wish the pair of you.
What?
Now, don't you worry, Stu. Remember, at the end of the day, the judge will decide. All you need to do is hold your head up high, speak clearly, and do it like we've rehearsed, okay?
How long has that been in now?
20 minutes.
Oh, good sign. Any time I've been in, it's been wham bam, thank you, Tam.
Where's the
Struan?
Hey! Oh. It's my wife, you bastard!
Struan, hold yourself together. Show a bit of self-respect.
Struan's right. You're a whore.
How did we fare?
Oh, fine. Here, Struan. Fine. In retrospect, it may have been a good idea to have a proper lawyer, but you know, I held my own, even when they said things I didn't quite understand. But overall, I'd say ours is what you would call a moral victory.
Oh. Well, good. We're good to go, then.
Oh, yes, indeed. Now, Struan, son, Struan. Here. Now, Struan, son. This is yours to keep. That's the restraining order. Any contact by phone or coming within a mile or a half of her, he gets to jail. Right. Let's go for a drink.
Drink.
Boyd, maybe we've made a mistake.
What are you saying?
Well, sometimes I wonder if we've made a mistake moving here.
You think so?
Well, I don't know.
Oh, come on. It's not that bad. Think of all that fresh air. This fantastic house. Look at the size of that garden. I'd never have been able to dig graves for all those dead animals in our old place.
Hey, Robertson, what can we do you for?
I'm here for a kilt.
Kilt? Oh, sorry, no kilts here. Sorry, can I help you there, son? Come on, out of my shop. Come on. I'm just kidding you. It's a wee bit of kinology there, a wee bit of kinology you like. So is it for the competition?
It is, aye. Are you going to be there?
Oh, yes. We're doing bits and pieces. You know what they say? If you're hiring a hall, give fingers a call. No, I mean, this is a great time of year for us. I mean, I've got three guys flat out through the back there, pattern cutting all the time. And here's Louise on the till. She's the lovely Louise, just cashing up there. Every night her eyes are dashed near popping out of her head when she gets to that Zen reading, yes. But don't linger too long, Louise. She's supposed to be signing on. Just kidding. So what have you got in mind? Because, look, there are tartans and tartans. But let me tell you this, that in the 18 months that I have been in this business, I have never yet come across a surname that I could not find a tartan for. So what's your surname?
Lachlan.
Lachlan, right. We'll get you the Lachlan tartan. Malky, look for the L book.
The midnight train is whining low. I'm so lonesome I could cry.
Here, Isabel, what do you reckon to this wee shoe? Not bad for that wedding in September. Mind you, the heel, not so good in the grass.
Why do we get a sandal then, flat thing? Let your toes breathe at the front.
No, there's something about a heel that makes me feel different.
What, a little more womanly?
No, just taller.
Right, Hayley, come on, let's have a look at you.
Did you get her that cape?
I did, yes. Hayley, can we see the outfit, please?
Oh, boy. Something off a biscuit tin.
I bet there's very few people there that'll be able to afford this kind of thing.
And what does the star of the show herself think about it?
She loves it.
Right, Lachlan, we'll just flip through here. You've got Lamont, you've got Lamont Modern, I think that, Lennox, Lindsay, and that's...
As you know, it's a tradition of the competition that the holders of the Cup of Kindness mark the great man's immortal memory with a gift of some sort. Okay. So it was decided at the last meeting that we would commission a commemorative bust of Robert Burns himself.
About?
About, yes. Debbie, if you would, please, sir.
Said bust will be transported to Alloway on the day of the competition by a man with a van who I found by means of a card that I found at the foot of the till in Morrison's.
That's excellent. Well, now all we need to do is contact
the point of order. As you know, I am well known amongst the hired van community of Dunfries and could have secured terms doubtless more favourable than those agreed by crony Cameron.
I resent that, Mackay. I went to a considerable amount of trouble in that negotiation. In fact, I stood for 45 minutes in a disabled parking waiting for said man in van to arrive. And by the time he did, my frozen food was no longer frozen, therefore forcing me to eat the entire lot in a one-eye that evening.
OK, Lou, can we just get back to the bus,
please, gentlemen? Two individual lasagnas, a cod and butter and parsley sauce, a bag of garden peas...
Cameron...
I just can't match up this Lachlan name. Have you got any other name you think that I could look up for you? You know, someone that's important to you, somebody that you're maybe connected with? Oh, come on, son, we're busy.
You could try the lassie at work. Did I tell you I'm going to propose to her?
Right, that's it. Now we're in business. What's her surname?
Zaheer.
A substantial baked Alaska. A pepperoni pizza, hot and spicy.
Oh, Struan, come in.
Oh, have a drink.
Also, a packet of puff pastry.
It's Struan, son, nice to see you.
Lovely golden
corn
in the corn as well.
You shushed, for God's sake.
Sorry to interrupt you.
And a Struan, white magnum.
Cameron! What can we do for you?
Well, You know I've got a lot on my plate at the minute.
Of course.
We're the only one.
That's enough. Of course we do, and we all know that. Of course we do.
Well, it's just that I'm up to here with it.
Of course you are, and we, you know, we want you to know that we are deeply sympathetic to your current plight, aren't we?
Aye, she's a whore.
Oh, she's a cow.
And we are here to support you, and we want you to think of us as your rock.
That's great, because you see the competition.
Aye.
I'm not doing it.
Hey? What?
No.
Now that is fantastic. You're very lucky, son, because that's unique. That's a one-off. You see, that's the new Burns tartan that we've just brought out. That's the hunting Burns.
The hunting Burns, Gibby.
That's what he wore when he was out hunting pheasants and doing the shopping.
Dude, his messages.
Marvellous. Right, now I'll just get a few measurements here because. I'm your man. Gibby's your man.
Gibby McPherson. Fingers McPherson. What's the fingers for, Gibby? Where does that come from?
Just hold on, son. That's it, smashing. That's a nice length.
Well, this is our local.
Yeah, our safe haven.
This is where everyone in the village gathers. We love it here, don't we?
Yeah, I'm always pulling Tommy's leg. He's the landlord, mine host. I'm always saying, come on, Tommy, when are you going to get a barrel of good old-fashioned Kentish ale in, eh? Mm-hmm.
Hello, everyone! Oh, hiya! Hello, Tommy!
Evening.
Leaving. All right, Thomas, my old fellow.
Usual, please.
Is Jean not working tonight?
No, she's not. She's got family trouble.
Oh, no, that is bad news. What is it they say? You can pick your friends, but not your family, eh?
Our sister's died.
Oh, no. Well, we must do her one of our fruit baskets. Oh, dear, what a shame. So, Tommy.
Aye?
Well, you know I'm doing the Tam O'Shanter poem. What was that bit we were trying to work out? Oh yeah, a blenheim.
Oh, yeah.
A blethering, blustering,
drunken blenheim. Mm. I mean, what the bloody hell is that? A blenheim.
Someone that's full of shite.
Oh.
Okay.
I stand up again.
Deep breaths, shoulders back, chin up, chest out. You're saying this to the woman you love.
Oh, my love's like a red, red rose.
Great, come on, let's hear it.
Come on, Pet, dress rehearsal time. Come on, Hayley, don't you dare piss me and your gran about. She's an awful shy wee girl.
She's at it.
Right, Hayley, we just want to hear the poem.
How does it go again? How's it start? Wee something something.
Mousy.
Wee mousy. Wee scuttling, twitching thing me. What is it? How's it nice to pick up?
I don't know. Just go up and grab it.
Oh. Haley! Haley, don't you dare you! She's locked herself in the bathroom now, isn't she?
Oh, that's my standards.
Well, he's closing early tonight, is Tommy.
Yeah, that'll be out of respect for Jean's sister. It's one of the things about these smaller communities. They're very tight-knit. Mm. Come on.
Right.
What's the matter? Are you nervous about the competition? Listen, we're all nervous. Your gran's nervous. I'm nervous. I'm on my second bottle of wine down there. Listen, Haley, Mummy's not angry with you. Okay, let's count to 10. 1, 2, 3. Haley, get your arse out here now, lady!
Let me try. I know what I'm doing. Haley, come on now, love. Your gran's needing in for a jobby.
And I will come again, my love. Though it were 10,000 miles.
Twere.
Twere? All right. And I will come again, my love. Though it twere 10,000 mile. All right. Well, I better get back to my cell.
I think we should keep practicing. The last stanza, there's still a bit more we could do with that.
Well, I've got to go, though.
No, you don't.
Well, I do. What's my turn for the pawn?
Why is she like this? She doesn't know, you know. She doesn't know. After everything I have done for her, she does not know how hard it is to keep all this going on your own, because everything here, it all costs money. Money! It wasn't her that her father deserted. Oh, no, it was me. I was the one that was left carrying all this on my shoulders. Right, I'm going to go phone Brian.
You are not phoning him.
Mum, I just want to talk to him.
But there is no point.
Why not?
Because Bangkok is 8 hours ahead and he's on stage.
I'm having a breakdown here.
Henry Strong, breathe.
No, this isn't the first time she was like this. She did exactly the same for the grade four for the ballet. Oh, my God, that was horrendous. Everyone, the whole neighbours, they were all out the front watching me lying, greeting in the driveway in my goonie. Oh, help me! Please help me! Wait, how much is that, I owe you?
£22.75.
How are you feeling, son, eh?
Hellish. I just feel I can't cope with it, you know, I can't sleep. I'm all over the place. My life's a mess. It's a total mess.
No, that's true. That's not true. That's just not true.
My wife left me, you know. She objected strongly to the fact that I was sleeping with another woman.
She will not leave you. It's just a blip.
It's a blip.
I wonder what she's doing. What time is it? She'd just be having her muesli now. I'm going to phone her.
No, you can't do that. You see, you'll get the jail.
Well, now, Struan, son, look. Now, listen to me. The judge forbade you to speak to her, right? But he did not forbade us. So we went over last night and spoke to her.
Did you?
Uh-huh.
What did she say? Was he there?
No. We don't know. We're not sure one way or the other. But the point is this. She quite specifically said to us she'd be prepared to take you back.
Yes!
Struan, wait. Let's not get carried away. There were some conditions, though.
Well, tell me, what were they? I'll do anything.
You have to pull yourself together.
Uh-huh. Clean up your act.
And go ahead and enter the competition.
Oh. Then she'll take me back?
Almost certainly.
Oh, I knew it! I knew she didn't want him! I knew we weren't finished! Oh, God! You have no idea how much better I feel already! Come on!
Yeah, I mean, huge it is. I mean, it's huge.
Massive.
Yeah, I mean, like Burns Night, it's biggest night of the year, isn't it?
Oh,
and I mean, easily. Oh, hey, now, look, I'm not knocking Christmas.
No.
I mean, that is very popular, obviously. Mm. And I'm not knocking Jesus either. No, he was a good man, too. Mm-hmm. But Burns, well,
He's known worldwide.
And I mean, when it comes to the competitions, we get them all. Kids, adults, asylum seekers trying to get brownie points. It's great.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
You're one of the competitors, are you?
I am, uh-huh.
What poem are you doing, love?
A man's a man for all that.
Table 3A.
Thank you.
So what me and the rest of the judges are going to be looking for tonight is clarity of speech, dramatic impact, and remembering the lines. People are free to interpret the poetry in any way they like, but the one thing we do try to discourage is over-theatricality. That and male competitors going commando under their kilts. Well, at least letting us know they've done that.
Leslie, she knows I get nervous. She won't mind if I phone quickly. No, just for a chat. Nothing bad.
I don't think that's a good idea at the moment. I'll tell you what. Let's call her after. After you've won the cup, eh? Hey, listen, Cameron will call her just now, won't you, Cameron?
Hey, no bother.
Come on, son.
I've got a number.
Don't you worry about it.
Oh, boy, come on.
I'm looking.
We've been down here twice already.
I know.
I mean, did you not get the directions from the internet? Well, did you? You didn't, did you?
Go to that church again.
I mean, did you want me to miss it? Do you? I mean, you do. You don't want me to do it. You don't want to go. In fact, you don't want to be here at all. I know where you'd rather be.
Oh, shut up!
Oh, go on, admit it. You hate this place.
Yeah, well, maybe I do. We're clearly not welcome. We're not safe.
Well, where would you feel safe?
Paula, don't start.
Go on, where would you feel safe? I mean, I know exactly where you feel safe. I mean, I know. Back in Berkshire in some travelling tub to be prepared with that 22-year-old slut!
Excuse me.
Yes, my dear, how can I help?
Hello, I'm Robert Lachlan.
Oh, right, are you one of the competitors? Right, you need to go over to trestle table number 3A and register there.
It's a nice cup, that. What tartan's that?
It's Burberry.
Oh, right. Well, Miss Burberry, where do I go again?
Just over to the table there, 3A, and see Morven. She'll sort you out.
It's the Burns tartan there. On shopping tartan,
like. Is that so, my honey? Mm-hmm.
Aye. Gibby said to me that if I see this tartan anywhere in here tonight, I'll be very surprised. Do you know Gibby? Gibby Fingers McPherson. Do you know why they call him Fingers?
I do, yes.
We want to transfer the bust from the trolley to the table, OK? The guy said it was smashing.
It's quite heavy.
A real authority, apparently.
Really quite heavy.
The look of a leader.
But, how much does it cost to get done, just out of interest?
Right.
Hey. Hold your horses, Mackay. What? Jump the gun as per usual, you absolute arse.
Oh.
Miko.
Gentlemen. Fellow members of the Dumfriesburn Society, raise your glasses, please.
The Bard.
The Bard.
The Bard.
Oh. Was that no Napoleon?
Will you stop footering with your feather? Right, competitors only, you're in there.
Oh, this is beautiful, Elizabeth. Look at that. All the tartan and the bagpipes. You make me very emotional, the pipes. Remind me of your father.
What, did he play the pipes?
No, but the guy that he left me for was in the Dragoons.
I really don't think there's any need to keep him chained to you like an animal.
Oh, those were the orders, I'm afraid.
Hatshaw! Oh,
for
God's sake. Oh, sorry. You don't have a hanky, do you?
Get your hands off me.
Oh, Paula.
I don't want to discuss it anymore. Thank you.
How many times do I have to say I'm sorry? I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I slept with another woman. I'm sorry that I booked a hotel, collected a woman from work, took her to the hotel, and had sex with her on a B-day.
Shh, you're drawing attention to us!
And so, without further ado, we begin this year's competition with Elizabeth Kerr from Elgin performing Two Lives.
Where have you gone, you crowling fairly? Your impudence protects you, Sirly.
I Ping it again, please.
Sorry.
What am I going to do? Who am I going to see? What have I done wrong? I've done it wrong.
You're just trying to do the same note.
Devotion. Next up, performing Robert Bruce's March to Bannockburn, it's the Timorous Beastie Boys.
Oh, that's a clever name.
Scots were here with what bled. Scots from Bruce has often led. And welcome to your gory bed. On to victory.
Now, Salma, you made it. Sorry, I've not been on yet.
You sure?
I think so.
Well, good luck.
Make sure you're watching. I've got a surprise for you. Could be a night to...
Remember.
Aye, remember.
For God's sake, pal, can you not take a Beecham's or something for that?
Excuse me.
This is no way for him to prepare, you know. You're putting him at a disadvantage. This is an abuse of his human rights.
I am just doing my job.
Well, I need a piss.
He needs to urinate.
Oh, come on, then.
Oh, for God's sake!
Well, you better not sneeze while I've got my knob in my hand.
"'Twas in that place of Scotland's isle
that bears the name of old King Coyle.
Upon a bonny day in June,
when wearing through the afternoon,
twa dogs that were nae thrang at hame
for gie their dainth upon a time.
The first on name,
that no just melt your heart, that. Aye. Lovely.
His hair, his size, his mouth, for his a fag.
Aye.
But well put someplace far abroad.
No, I think you've done it, Let's have a look at this. That's not bad. Oh, OK, yeah, good. Let's try this. Let's have a look at that. Bit of an angle there. John, there we go.
Oh.
Huh? Well, nice.
Lovely. Eh?
We're there.
Lovely.
This is one that helped me get through my time in rehab a great deal and helped me come to terms with the fact that I am an addict. Thank you. Charlie is my darling. My darling, my darling. Charlie is my darling, a young cavalier.
Ah, it's all right, son. Sometimes I kind of do it with somebody beside me here. Beside me? You were practically holding it.
And now we have Hayley Braid from East Kilbride performing Tamers.
You'd think they'd put a wee something down for folk to sit in that are out having a fag. You're treated like a bloody leper. I mean, look at that. There's not even something to stub yourself out in. There's one thing I did right when I was bringing you up. At least I taught you how to use an ashtray.
Poor and timorous beastie, oh, what a panic's in thy breastie.
Oh, have you got a fag there?
Oh, give him one of yours, Isabel. So how's it going?
All right, aye. There's a wee girl on there now, it's quite good.
Oh, is that?
She's done up like a Christmas tree, though, and Sheila will hate that.
That's ridiculous, some of the get-ups. The parents are just making a cod out the wains. They're not serious about the poetry. No. They know nothing about rabbi buns.
So have you got someone in it as well, then?
Yeah. Me? I am doing it.
Oh, really? What are you doing?
A fond kiss.
All right. Who's that by?
This is my moment, Boyd. My day.
Oh, just settle down. Just simmer down.
We'll mount it on his great man, Meg.
Stop it, please!
Come on, she's not that bad.
Oh, are you okay?
Yeah.
Ah!
How are you doing, son? You set?
Yeah, I think so. I am just going to go and ring Leslie. I've got
2 minutes. No. Listen, you don't have time. You're up there in a minute or two. We don't have...
Look at all the lovely cards that were sent to the house.
Look at this from your well wishes. Who we got here? Look, from Sadie Coyle at the Red Lion.
Yes.
Struan. Oh, everybody in the crowd. Oh, a nice bunch down there. Oh, well, don't need that. And this is...
From the lawyers, isn't it? I recognise that.
No, it's nothing. And he's from all the staff. At the silver tassie and tavern there. They're a nice bunch.
So she wants a divorce?
Now, some bad news. Robert Loughlin is unfortunately not able to perform, which is a shame. Poor wee lamb, he'll be needing one of my cuddles. Yeah. But we'll move quickly on to our next competitor, representing Dumfries.
Oh, it's us.
Struan Robertson. Allowed to give me that. You should know off by heart.
A fond kiss. And then we sever. A farewell, alas, forever. Deep in heart wrung tears are pledged.
Come on, Struan, do it for Dumfries, come on. Hold yourself together, boy.
Warring sighs and groans, I'll wage thee.
Struan!
What do you mean you've been on?
Welcome onto the stage, Paula Pickford performing Tam O'Shanter.
When Chapman Billies leave the street and Druthy neighbours meet,
had been sae wise as take thy aim wife Kate's advice.
And hutched and blew with might and main till thirsty caper sin anither. Tam tint is risen at the gither and roars out
here. There's a guy out there about to top himself.
Struan!
Don't stay put, my darling. Stay put. He won't jump, they never do.
Struan, son! Struan, come
stay
on.
Stay away
here.
From me. Stay back.
Struan,
you lied to me. You lied. I knew.
I didn't.
You told me she wanted me back.
Well. We all have to make sacrifices for the greater good.
But I've lost my wife.
And we'll lose a bloody cup.
Stay back! I'm warning you. I'll do it. I will. I'll dump.
That's soon. This isn't necessary. There is still hope. All is not lost.
Is there?
Yes. I can talk to Sheila. She'll let you go back on.
I'm sick of it. I can't do it anymore. You're mad. You're feeding off me. When all you're interested in yourselves. I'm the one that has to learn it all. I'm the one that has to stand up there while my life is falling apart. It's easy for you. You just sit there getting pissed. Aye, when you go, Struan. Oh, pull yourself together, Struan. Don't let us down, Struan. My wife is shagging her cousin.
But we don't know that for a fact.
Oh, we do so, Mikko. She is.
No,
no point
in
telling a boy lies.
Oh, no! Get up!
Is it cold? I wonder what brought that on.
Remember, Tam or Shanter's mare.
Oh dear. Let's see why she's away with the cousin.
Does my hair look all right, eh?
Your hair?
Ah.
Hang on. You're not going on.
Oh, come on, big man. You can't stand up there like a big streak of pish watching me doing my bit.
No, watch it.
He can't perform shackled, for the love of God.
The governor said cuffed at all times.
Come on, this is art. It's about language and love and freedom to express. It's not about handcuffs and keys. It's about humanity, trust.
And I don't want to look like a tit.
All right, then.
I'll not forget this, Mr. Souter.
You wee bastard! Give me back those tights!
Don't take advantage.
Stevie.
My love is like a red, red rose that's newly sprung in June. Oh, my love is like the melody that's sweetly played in tune. As fair art thou, my bonny lass, so deep in love am I. And I will love thee still, my dear, till all the seas gang dry. Till all the seas gang dry, my dear, and the rocks melt with the sun. And I will love thee still, my dear, while the sands of life shall run. And fare thee weel, my only love, and fare thee weel a while. And I will come again, my love, though it were 10,000 miles.
Oh, it's marvellous.
Thanks. Thanks very much. I really need that piss.
Ah, you're all right, aren't you?
Aye.
Aye, go on.
Cheers.
That was brilliant.
Well, first of all, can I just say how super I thought you all were? There wasn't one of you that didn't do yourselves proud, even those of you that burst into tears and couldn't come on. We souls, that's nerves, isn't it? But we've thought long and hard about it, myself and the other judges that can still talk, and we feel that this year's award for excellence in recitation of the work of Rabbi Burns and the recipient of the Cup of Kindness should be... Stevie Kerr with a red ribbon!
This is technically a void contest, and as I recall, the rules quite clearly state that the cup should stay with the current holder, which I think you will find is in fact Dumfries member Struan Robertson.
Away with your shite! My daughter has knocked her pan in for weeks. Weeks getting ready for this.
You didn't even see her do it.
Yeah, what exactly does that mean, knocking your pan in?
Now don't you start, you English bastard!
Oh, no, it's racist.
like Sheila. Rules are rules, you know that.
This whole thing cost me a bloody fortune. I'm a single parent.
Oh, are you indeed?
Slap her back. She was rubbish.
Oh, will someone help me out here, please? He's God's sake, for God's sake!
Tonight, the night of this woman, let's get the set.
Salma, I was wondering, there was something I wanted to ask you.
Yeah?
Would... No, it's gone. I had something to...
It was just one of those things, really.
Yeah.
Good experience, definitely.
Oh, yeah. Things just didn't go our way.
We certainly had some fond memories. But I've always thought, Paula, if there's one place you could settle and really fit in, it would be Wales.
Wales.
Yeah.
I feel I've come a long way since the competition. You know, obviously, certain things in my life have changed. I've got a new job and all that. But I tell you this, the new job's really helped me overcome my fears, you know? Empowerment. That's what they call it.
Yeah, it's been tough. It certainly has. But good comes from everything, you know, because if I hadn't gone through that, I'd never have got together with Susan here, would I?
No.
It's amazing, really. You know, she is both my best friend and my wife.
Cousin. Oh, I get the ski boots, the salopettes, beautiful ski jacket, goose feather
Isabel,
lining inside.
That's
yes.
The police here.
Is Isabel Braid?
Well, depends who's asking for it. Like, wait a wee minute, get your hands up. Right, you need to get on to legal. If you could just cut there, because let's end on a high.
Hey.
How long's Mummy away on holiday for?
Oh, about 3 years.
Good morning, gentlemen. Now, I know you lot all think that prison is an easy ride. That I'm a soft touch, all poetry and weaving. Well, let me tell you, nothing could be further from the truth. You're a shower of bastards, and you're here to be punished.
Mr. President, if I may, after lengthy conversations and discussions with all my fellow committee members, we have decided that it's high time you, Meikle McMeikle, after all the service you have given Dumfries Burn Society, should resign. All those in favour say aye.
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 Wait a minute. Who's going to be president? What?
We are.
The Bard!
The Bard!